Robinson's joke.
Hey everyone, it's Alex the Real Mr. Robinson here. I'm at Disneyland right now. I just needed one day to just come here, especially since I heard that the Main Street Electrical Parade is back, which is a parade that I've been told by my parents I've seen. I don't remember seeing it at all, so I figured to devote this day to a random video blog and, mainly focused on the magical parade, so let's get to it. You know, I can say, since I now am officially a Disneyland pass holder after who knows how long, there are two things that I've learned to do. One, never take the Disney tram from the parking lot to Downtown Disney, because you will be waiting in that crowd forever. And two, if you're going to make any shortcuts, make sure it hasn't rained the night before, that the employees didn't water the lawn, because your shoes are going to be ending up like as muddy as mine are. Oh, but these shoes survive. These shoes are fine, but these, no. I know they're dirty, but it's kind of a cool color palette or pattern. I don't know, I'll wash it off later. But that's just a little pro tip for anyone coming to Disneyland that I think people already know. So that, I don't know. But I also wanted to try to get back into doing more theme park related videos, because if you look on my channel banner, it says movie reviews, let's plays, podcasts, theme parks. Haven't done theme park videos in a while. The last one I did was actually Halloween Horror Nights 2015, so I want to try to get back in that groove more, especially since I can now go to Disney and Universal whenever I want. So yeah, I mean, without further ado, let's get out of Downtown Disney and head to Disneyland and California Adventure. One new thing that they've done is they've moved all the security booths in front of the box office to be in front of Downtown Disney, which is fine, is good, I think, because you just get the check-in out of the way quickly, and if I ever have to take the monorail back into Downtown Disney to get something like a Jamba Juice, then I have to go back through security all over again. But so that's a good improvement. On with the vlog. Alright, so I'm inside Disneyland, and our first stop will be Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars. That's all the lyrics I remember. But yeah, Star Tours is first. So, Season of the Force has returned, but it looks like Star Tours is closed? It didn't say that on the app, but right, here's banners of Jyn Erso, Saw Gerrera, K2SO, Yoda way back there. And there's the Across the Stars Left and Right plane. And on this side we have an Imperial Death Trooper with TIE Strikers, TIE Pilots with TIE Strikers, a Stormtrooper up there, Palpatine, Darth Vader, Kylo Ren, and the list goes on. Okay, so Star Tours has a 50-minute wait. It is open, but 50 minutes I'm kind of not the patience for right now, so we're... Look, that's okay, because Hyperspace Mountain has our backs. Gotta get a Star Wars fix somehow with only... Okay, I swear to God, when I was started recording, it said 35 minutes. Now it's 25 minutes. This is the one time Space Mountain is not the longest line in the park. So this is awesome. Something is really weird when there's not a lot of people in this section of the line. I would say that goes to show you how non-busy the day is, but I don't work here, so I don't know. And with Star Tours being a 50-minute wait, it's gotta be busy somehow. But hey, 25-minute wait for Space Mountain, not complaining at all.
Whether peak season or not, it's always a great idea to start Disneyland with Space Mountain. And I gotta say, Hyperspace Mountain is really cool. Basically just Space Mountain with Star Wars. And as much as I love it, I do wish they would bring back regular Space Mountain soon. I think they're just holding off until Star Wars Land opens 2 years from now. Which it's too long of a wait for both regular Space Mountain and Star Wars Land. So, I still have yet to go on Star Tours because the line is still too long, so I'm heading towards Adventureland. There we will go ride their best ride there, ironically based off another Lucasfilm property.
Alright, so I've decided to do Star Tours a little later. I got myself a fast pass, so we're all good to go. So I'm here at Adventureland. So let's do Indiana Jones. Apparently it has a 25-minute wait as well. What is this world coming to where both Space Mountain and Indiana Jones have short wait times?
25 minutes or you can get a fast pass.
And yet Peter Pan will still have an hour wait. There's nothing you can change about Peter Pan.
Indiana Jones always has the best theme of any attraction. Just so great detail next to Harry Potter and the Forbidden Journey. It's just a marvel to look at, just the surroundings. And it's really cool to see the Jungle Cruise boats go past the attraction as well. The insides are always great. Although one thing that I've really begun to notice about Indiana Jones that I don't think anyone ever brought to attention is the John Williams music doesn't play while you're walking around. It's just noise of like droplets from the caverns, jungle noises, no John Williams music. Also, by the way, if you're wondering why the camera is suddenly so blurry and it's cutting frames, this is the low light setting on my camera, so I do apologize. Not really the best way to film darkly lit areas, but I can't afford a camera that has true night vision, so I do apologize if it's annoying to you. After Indiana Jones, I headed towards Splash Mountain, which to this day, it still baffles me that one of Disneyland's most popular rides is based off one of their most, if not their most, controversial movie ever made. Song of the South has yet to be released on Blu-ray or even DVD. Maybe not even VHS. But I really would be curious to see it one day and, if possible, do a retro review on it. So after Splash Mountain, I went right back to Tomorrowland to the Star Wars Launch Bay, where this year they had a bunch of really cool models and some props from Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Like they had a model of Director Krennic's shuttle, they had Shore Trooper armor, they had a model for the Rebel Alliance U-Wing, Cassian Andor's blaster, Jyn Erso's outfit that she steals from an Imperial engineer. But I was actually at Disneyland last year when they had a bunch of models from The Force Awakens being displayed, because at that time The Force Awakens was still in the theaters. And I don't know why I never got around to uploading this video. Just had it on reserve for a whole year. But yeah, back then they had like the T-70 X-Wing, Rey's scavenger suit, a flame trooper, the First Order TIE fighter on display, Captain Phasma's helmet. It was just really cool. Launch Bay is a great place to hang out when I just need to get away from all the crowds of Disneyland.
Alright, so it's around the time I can use my fast pass for Star Tours. Let's do that right now. Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars. I already made that joke. And of course, when I get a fast pass, the line's shorter. 35 minutes. Oh well. Yeah, I think the day's starting to pick up a little more, but whatever. Star Tours. So it's time to leave Main Street, or Disneyland as a whole, for now, because I'm going to jump ship to California Adventure. So obviously I'll be back at Disneyland because the main reason I came here was to see the electrical parade for the first time that I'll remember it, because again, I've been told I've seen it before, but don't remember it. So we're going to jump ship over to California Adventure. Which I gotta say, ever since I got Disneyland Pass, it's been so cool and weird at the same time to park hop.
Because usually when I come here, or before I got a pass, it was just like, you either get Disneyland or you get California Adventure. You can't get both. And now I can get both. So yeah, let's head into California Adventure. All right, so this is actually the second time I've been in the revamped California Adventure since its grand opening. I went here, I guess, for the first time since it had its grand reopening a couple months ago. So I'd never done Cars Land before. I never did Soarin' Over the World. I never got to explore California Adventure after its big renovation. So now I'm going to do a second time actually record it. So let's, I say this a lot, but let's go. So this here used to be the Golden Gate Bridge before they did their big renovation. And that right ahead is the theater where Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs first premiered back in 1937. Oh my lord, that movie's 80 years old. The very first animated movie ever is 80 years old. But yeah, this is supposed to be like old Hollywood, which is cool. Still a little weird that they took away Tower of Terror in place for Guardians of the Galaxy, which does not really fit old Hollywood or Hollywood in general, but hopefully it'll be a cool ride. There's a statue of Walt and Mickey. No big deal, just walking down Hollywood Boulevard. There's the El Capitan off in the distance where it's playing Pinocchio. Obviously, this is not the real one. There's, where is he? There's Captain America.
Oh, look, it's Spider-Man!
And Spidey. Two of the best heroes ever. So here's the former site of the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror, which is the only ride ever to, like, legitimately scare me. But now it's being refurbished into Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout. And little Rocket Raccoon's paws here. And it says Escaping Summer 2017, so just a little bit after Volume 2 comes out.
So here we are at Cars Land. Now, as much as I think Cars is a less than stellar Pixar movie, no matter how many people try to argue with me that it's a masterpiece, Cars Land is amazing. It's really goes to show how great Disney Imagineering is. They literally make a land where you feel like you're transported to another place. You don't feel like you're at a theme park when you're in Cars Land. You feel like you've been transported into the desert. The setting is just so beautiful, and there's never a moment at all where you see any other attractions off in the distance when you're in Cars Land. No, you really, as I've said before, get the feeling that you're in the desert. Radiator Springs Racers is a really cool ride also. Basically, it's our equivalent to Test Track at Epcot, which I've actually been on. I like Test Track a lot. Although one thing that confuses me is that when you look at the queue for the ride, when it posts a 90-minute wait, this queue looks way too small to hold a 90-minute wait, so I'm wondering where everyone else goes. But regardless, Cars Land is pretty awesome, even though the movies are pretty meh. After Cars Land, I checked out the Little Mermaid ride, which was cheesy, but it was somewhat enjoyable. I found some old toys from my childhood that were basically these paper airplanes that you put together and toss around, and then found some cats roaming around the park. Interesting. Whoa, this one's not shy about walking towards me at all. All right, time to head back to Disneyland.
Now we're heading back to Disneyland. I decided to use my phone for a bit, just so I can save battery in my camera for when the electrical parade starts. But yeah, fun time at California Adventure for a bit. Now we're just gonna spend the rest of the evening at Disneyland until the parade starts.
So cut forward to later in the evening when everybody's starting to get ready for the Disneyland parade. I mainly stayed in Tomorrowland just so I could be close to Main Street and get a good spot. But it was really exciting to be able to see the parade. I waited 20 minutes for the parade to start. And then it started. The lights went down, everyone was cheering, the music started playing, Disney's Main Street Electrical Parade was about to start. Later, the music was playing for a good 2.5 minutes before the floats actually started coming along. And then the first one peeked around the corner and was moving incredibly slow. Man, that's kind of harsh, but it had me laughing. But regardless, once the floats actually started to pop up to where I was, it was really cool. I mean, I don't usually stay for Disney parades, to be totally honest, but I've always heard of the Main Street Electrical Parade. I've listened to the music several times. I have the music on my iPhone, and to be able to see it in person was absolutely amazing. I don't know, it makes you turn into a kid where all the pretty lights just catch your attention. You're just in love with it. It was a trip well spent. So I leave Disneyland with the castle right there, tiny as can be. And today was a fun day. The electrical parade was cool. It moved slowly, but then again, I don't see many parades here at Disneyland, so maybe they all move slowly. But I was hoping to take the monorail back, but it's closing time and the monorail closes at 9 exactly, or maybe a little earlier. But anyway, just heading back to Main Street, walking through downtown Disney into my car. So I hope you enjoyed this journey through Disneyland with me today. I'll try to make an effort this year to put up more theme park videos, Universal, Disney, or anything else. So leave a comment down below and tell me what you thought of this vlog. Like, comment, subscribe, share me with your friends. Don't forget to check out my official website. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Periscope, Rift.tv, where I'm continuing my marathon of the Clone Wars series, at least until they get rid of the Clone Wars on Netflix comes. But whatever the case, if it does happen, I do have a backup commentary series planned, and I see people photobombing me. And until then, this is the real Mr. Robinson telling you there's only one. Oh, I forgot one last thing. Here's nightmare fuel for you. Okay, bye.